And tonight we have new information on a deadly officer-involved shooting that happened back in June. Today the district attorney held a press conference to talk about their findings in the case. Our Olivia Doles is live outside the courthouse. So first of all, Olivia, what did the district attorney's office determine in the case?
Yeah, Courtney, district attorney Ernie Lee ruled the shooting was justified based on the evidence. Jamie Mitchell was killed in the shooting after investigators say he fired at deputies. On Thursday morning, District Attorney Ernie Lee revealed the results of months of investigating the actions of officers that led to the death of Jamie Mitchell. Investigators say the 39-year-old was shot and killed on June 5th by two officers after barricading himself and others inside the house on New River Drive for hours.
The shooting death of Jamie Mitchell is found by me to be justified to protect the safety and lives of the law enforcement officers from potential harm as perceived by law enforcement officers at the scene.
This video from Sandy Run Missionary Baptist Church was shared during the press conference, showing Mitchell outside shooting at police and officers firing back. A total of 14 casings from officers were found at the house, while District Attorney Lee says Mitchell shot a total of 3 times, twice inside and once outside. Fellow officers say they feel Lee's ruling is not surprising.
Having been, you know, through situations like this and knowing what all of the facts were, and going forward, it was the expected result.
Though this day is still in the back of the minds of many Jacksonville police officers, Deputy Chief Weaver says at the end of the day, it was necessary to protect others.
Still a tragedy in what had happened, but the fact that we were able to get the rest of the family out safely, we take every win that we can, and that was definitely a win that night.
District Attorney Lee said he reached out to the family members of Jamie Lee about the press conference today, but he did not hear back from them. Live in Jacksonville, Olivia Doles, WITN News.
All right, thanks, Olivia. And the State Bureau of Investigation took over the case on June 5th and worked on it alongside Jacksonville Police and the District Attorney's Office.